experience. So with that, Matt, it's my privilege to introduce you. We have delighted to introduce Senator Matt Schmidt from Red Wing. He's made broadband adoption his number one priority, and boy, it shows. We're going to hear a lot more about that this afternoon. So please join me in welcoming the good-looking, the fabulous Matt Schmidt, everybody.
Well, thank you, Bernadine, for the gracious introduction there. And thank you to the Blandin Foundation for all the work you've done in this space and on rural development, and in particularly broadband deployment in greater Minnesota. I think everybody in this room can appreciate the fact that we would not be here today without your efforts. So what we're hoping to do with our panel here is to build off of those efforts. And before I say another word, though, I'd just like to thank everybody for taking the time in your busy lives to come on down to St. Paul today and talk about this issue. I know many of us have been engaged in it for a long time, some longer than others. I feel like I'm Johnny come lately to this issue, but I got to tell you, I know how important this is and recognize that this is the great equalizer for many of our rural Minnesota communities, for our economic development, for our quality of life. And so thank you for taking the time to be engaged. And I also want to make a shout out to folks who are joining us online. Just because you're not able to join us today doesn't mean you can't contribute to this effort. In my mind, this is just the next step in building steady momentum for doing something significant at the state level behind broadband investment in Minnesota. And so I hope that we all take what we can from today's session, whether you're here in person, whether you're joining online, and that we continue the momentum and continue the engagement moving forward. I guess with that said, I'd just like to make a few quick remarks and then turn it over to a fantastic panel that we've assembled today. And I guess taking a step back, folks, you may know that we had a broadband listening tour throughout Minnesota. We call it the Border to Border Broadband Tour. It took place essentially in 2 weeks, one in mid-November and one in the first week in January. And I'm pretty sure we picked the coldest week of the decade at the time. I think we've been one up since then. But despite the cold and the fact that we had school cancellations, we had hundreds of folks show up around the state, all corners of the state, to talk about this very issue, how important broadband access is to our way of life, to our quality of life, to our economic growth. And I was just heartened by the stories I heard. I didn't necessarily know what to expect. We've certainly heard anecdotes and stories over the years on what's happening in Minnesota. And folks, if you're not convinced already, there is need for doing something. We're here today for a very specific reason, and that is to respond to that call to action and to galvanize our energy and to look forward for doing something constructively, building partnerships, collaboration, to get something done, to truly moving the dial. From this broadband listening tour, these 2 weeks, we had over 16 meetings. We had, throughout Minnesota, we had hundreds, nearly 500 people show up to these meetings to attend. We had folks from education, healthcare, agriculture, commerce, local government, economic development authorities all showed up to have great conversations. And our panel, our discussions tended to last about 90 minutes to 2 hours. And it really was a format that was up to those in attendance to dictate where we went. And I tried not to do much talking. I'm going to try to hold my comments to a minimum today too. But the value we took from that effort was so immense, and it impressed upon me the need for continuing the conversation and bringing it down here to St. Paul. So as I had mentioned, I think this is just the next step in elevating this discussion to St. Paul, and I hope next month when the session convenes to take this conversation up the hill into the Capitol and push for meaningful reform in the 2014 legislative session. If I could just make a couple quick comments and then we'll get our panelists up here. I view broadband really as the great equalizer in greater Minnesota, and I look at what our state is doing now in terms of our economic growth, place number fifth nationally coming out of the recession with 3.5% growth in 2012. We are at pre-recession employment numbers. There's a lot of great stories in Minnesota, but I'm also convinced that we're not firing on all cylinders yet, that we can do better, and that the way that we do better, the way that we reach our potential, is to get the creativity and the entrepreneurial spirit from all corners of the state engaged. And the way to do that is through 21st century infrastructure. So I hope that this session marks the beginning of a conversation at the state level where we're able to form those partnerships, look at resources, and build collaborative efforts moving forward. If I look at the effort that's happening in other states and compare that to what's happening here, I'm almost embarrassed. You know, many of us have gone to conferences in the past outside of Minnesota, and we see more and more states report
reporting on the initiatives that are underway in their areas. And more Minnesotans flocking to these conferences to hear what other states are doing. Folks, I think it's high time for Minnesota to be a leader in this area and for us to put our best foot forward. And I think now is the time. When you look at the 2014 session, we have, a couple different frames under which to look at the session. One is this unsession. And I think there's no area in public policy and in our statute that is a better fit for an unsession than telecom law. Folks, there are more references to the telegraph than to the internet in our current laws. That's ridiculous. I mean, that's ridiculous. It's 2014. So we've got to take a good hard look at our telecom and broadband laws, make sure that they reflect the realities of the 21st century. And secondly, and I imagine many of you would agree, broadband is the essential 21st century infrastructure. If we're going to talk about a bonding bill, if we're going to talk about roads and bridges, if we're going to talk about sewer and water, let's talk about broadband access everywhere throughout Minnesota. We're looking forward to getting some numbers back on what that would mean in terms of economic development and growth and job creation. I am convinced that this is the area for us to invest in Minnesota and to make sure that we maximize our private public investments in broadband so that we can be a leader in adoption, in service levels, in doing what we can with broadband. All right, I'm already, I think, reaching my point where I wanted to pull myself off the stage, but I just want to thank you folks again for engaging in this conversation and for showing up. I think if we're going to do anything, it's because of the groundswell, not in St. Paul, but throughout the rest of the state, of you contacting your legislators and contacting the folks who you trust to take your message and your priorities to St. Paul. And let's get the state of Minnesota involved in this conversation. We can form meaningful partnerships between the state, through local communities, through our providers, through our rich history of cooperatives in Minnesota. Let's play off of our strengths. We've got a lot of great things going for us in terms of the broadband that is available in greater Minnesota, and let's build off of that. And so I guess with that said, I'm going to quit talking. I'd love to get our panelists up here. So if you are a panelist, please come on up right now, and we'll cut to the chase here and hear from you. We have a rich panel that really touches upon a lot of different areas of broadband policy, the applications, whether it's telehealth or agriculture or e-commerce or education and distance learning, and local governments that want to chart a course for their own investments in broadband telecommunications infrastructure. Today you're going to get a sampling of those great stories that we heard on our broadband tour. We couldn't bring everybody down to tell their stories, but I got to tell you, what you're going to hear today is a great, capture of the value from that broadband tour. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce our first speaker here today. His name is David Collins, the Hubbard County Regional Economic Development Executive Director. David is a native of Nebraska and a rabid Husker fan. After that recent Gopher loss, I'm not sure, David. I don't know what to say. But he served as Executive Director of the Hubbard County Regional Economic Development Commission since moving to Minnesota in June of 2006. Previously, Collins managed chambers and development organizations in Iowa, Idaho, and Missouri, as well as the Associated Builders and Contractors of Nebraska. He also has held positions with the Nebraska Legislature, the Nebraska Republican Party, and the Dawson County Clerk's Office. Collins attended the University of Nebraska-Lincoln Institutes for Organizational Management and Institutes for Advanced Management, plus several other leadership programs. Without further ado, David, thank you for joining us, and we look forward to your remarks.
Okay. Well, I was hoping I need to go last and not first, but let's dive in. We live in rural Minnesota County, and it's a very per capita average, a very low income, especially in the city of Park Rapids. Economic development is very, very important to us, but we don't have commercial airports per se. We don't have natural gas pipelines. We don't have four-lane interstate, things like that. But what we do have, it's a place where people want to live, and it's where people want to bring their families. So our goal has been to try to make that quality of life, quality of place as strong as possible, and infrastructure to that is very, very important to us, as you all know. Jobs, the health care impacts. But we have over 50 resorts just in our county, and you would think people would want to get away from technology and the phones and the computers and so on when they come up and go to a resort to go fishing and things of that nature, but that's not the case. They almost demand and expect that right now to even consider a resort. Our schools recently got iPads for all of the middle school and high school students. But yet a lot of those students live, our school district is about 30 miles by 10 miles. And a lot of those students don't have the ability to access the internet when they take their iPads home at night. So that puts them at a real disadvantage to the other children in their classes. We formed a task force a number of years ago and through our Economic Development Commission and started visiting with some of the major telecommunications companies, CenturyLink, Arvig, Paul Bunyan, Communications, West Central, the Telephone Initiative, Charter, and then some of the others like Wild Blue, and so there's nobody to talk to really. But anyway, identifying which ones wanted to help us take rural broadband issues and get fiber to every home and every cabin within the county. And it's a tough issue. As you know, some are cooperatives, some are for-profits, but we did find some partners that were willing to work with that. In Park Rapids ourselves and in our corridor area, we've got CenturyLink, we've got Paul Bunyan, we've got Arvig, and to an extent West Central Telephone. So the good thing is we've got a lot of competition. The bad thing is that it divides up a very small market to begin with, so there's not a lot of incentive for them to keep investing and increasing speeds. And then once we get out of the immediate density of our population, it's even tougher to get them to do things in the rural areas. So we started working with one company in particular, and the Obama administration had the stimulus bill, and we helped get together an application, the letters of support, the whole works, and applied for stimulus funding to take broadband.